O Lord Jesus, my joy and my repose, I love thee. I love thee, my supreme and only good, with all my heart, with all my mind, with all my soul, and with all my strength. And if thou seest me lacking in this, at least I desire to love thee. Kindle, Lord, thy most ardent fire within my breast, and since thou askest naught of me but love, give what thou commandest, and command what thou dost will. For unless thou givest me both to will and do, I shall perish in mine infirmity. Let thy voice sound in my ears, that most sweet and efficacious voice which saith, I will. For if thou wilt, thou canst make me clean, enlighten, and raise me to the highest love. Since thou willest to suffer and to die for me, thou willest also that the fruit of thy passion and death be manifested in me. O think upon thy servant, as concerning thy word, wherein thou hast caused me to put my trust. For thou hast said, Whoso eateth my flesh and drinketh my blood, abideth in thee, and I in him. O most sweet saying, thou in me, and I in thee. O what great love! Thou in me a most vile wretch, and I in thee, my God, whose majesty is incomprehensible. One thing is needful for me, and this only will I seek, to live in thee, to rest in thee, never to be separated from thee. Blessed is he that seeketh thee, more blessed he that findeth thee, most blessed he that persevereth unto death in possession of thee. Live and reign ever in me, most faithful lover of my soul. For in thee are all good things. And now henceforth I am prepared for every ill, rather than ever cease to love thee. O most holy body, marked with five wounds, set them as a seal upon my heart. Imprint thereon thy charity. Sign my feet, that I may follow in thy steps. Sign my hands, that I may ever exercise them in good works. Sign my side, that for all eternity I pour forth most fervent acts of love towards thee. O most precious blood, which washest and purifiest every man, cleanse my soul and set thy seal upon my face, that I may have no other love but thee. Beloved of my heart, life of my soul, as thou art in the Father and the Father is in thee, so may I be joined in thee in love, and will by grace, and may the world be crucified unto me, and I unto the world. Amen.
Thank you.
Almighty God of our fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and of their righteous seed, who has made heaven and earth with all the array thereof, who has bound the sea by the word of thy commandment, who has shut up the deep and sealed it by thy terrible and glorious name, whom all men fear and tremble before thy power. For the majesty of thy glory cannot be borne, and thine angry threatening towards sinners is insupportable. But thy merciful promise is immeasurable and unsearchable. For thou art the most high Lord, of great compassion, long-suffering, very merciful, and repentest of the evils of men. Thou, O Lord, according to thy great goodness, hast promised repentance and forgiveness to them that have sinned against thee, and of thine infinite mercies hast appointed repentance unto sinners, that they may be saved. Thou, therefore, O Lord, thou art the God of the just, hast not appointed repentance to the just as to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, which have not sinned against thee, but thou hast appointed repentance unto me, that am a sinner. For I have sinned times above the number of the sands of the sea. My transgressions, O Lord, are multiplied, and I am not worthy to behold and see the height of heaven for the multitude of mine iniquities. I am bowed down with many iron bands, that I cannot lift up mine head, neither have any release. For I have provoked thy wrath, and done evil before thee. I did not thy will, neither kept I thy commandments. I have set up abominations, and have multiplied offences. Now therefore, I bow the knee of mine heart, beseeching thee of grace. I have sinned, O Lord. I have sinned, and I acknowledge mine iniquities. Be not angry with me forever, by reserving evil for me, neither condemn me into the lower parts of the earth. For thou art God, even the God of them that repent, and in me thou wilt show all thy goodness. For thou wilt save me, that am unworthy, according to thy great mercy. Therefore will I praise thee for ever all the days of my life. For all the powers of the heavens do praise thee, and thine is the glory for ever and ever. Amen. Lord, Master of my life, lead me not into the spirit of idleness and despondency, of ambition and vain speech, but give unto thy servant the spirit of chastity and humility, of patience and love. Yea, my Lord and King, give me to see my own transgressions, and to judge not my brother, for thou art blessed for evermore. Amen.
Thank you.
Christ my God, as if before thy dreadful judgment seat, where there will be no respect of persons. Even thus, coming to thy most holy altar, I bring before thee and thy majestic angels mine unrighteousness, mine evil thoughts and deeds. Behold my humility, I pray thee, Lord, and forgive my sins, which are more than the hairs of my head. For what evil is there that I have not committed in intention? What great and abominable works have I done? Have I not sinned through pride, vainglory, slander, vain speech, unkind laughter, gluttony, hatred, envy, covetousness, selfishness, ambition, and falsehood? Have I not defiled all my senses and the members of my body? And have I not become a slave to Satan? O Lord, I know well that mine iniquities have drowned me, but I know also that the number of thy mercies is infinite. The pitifulness of thy compassion passeth all understanding. Wherefore, O King, greater than all imagination, O long-suffering Lord, manifest that quality of goodness which is thy property. Stretch out thy most mighty right hand, and receive me as thou didst the returning prodigal, the repentant thief, and the woman who was a sinner. As the God of them that are penitent, and as the Saviour of sinners, save me for thy pity's sake, that where sin has abounded, their grace may yet more abound, that I may glorify thee with thy eternal Father, and thy most holy, gracious, and quickening Spirit, for ever and ever. Amen.
Oh.
cleanness and innocency of heart and uprightness of action. Give me humility, patience, self-discipline, chastity, prudence, justice, fortitude and temperance. Give me the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and strength, the spirit of knowledge and true godliness, and the spirit of thy holy fear. Make me ever to seek thy face with all the intent of my heart, my soul, and my mind. Grant me a contrite and humbled heart in thy presence, that I may prefer nothing to thy love. O most high, eternal, and ineffable wisdom, drive far from me the darkness of spiritual blindness and of ignorance. O most high and eternal strength, deliver me. Most high and eternal fortitude, assist me. Most high and uncircumscribed light, illuminate me. Most high and infinite mercy, have pity on me. Reading the Holy Scriptures. Truth is to be sought in the Holy Scriptures, not eloquence. All Holy Scripture should be read in the spirit in which it was written. We should seek profit in the Scriptures rather than subtlety of speech. We ought to read devout and simple books as willingly as those that are high and profound. Let not the authority of the author be in thy way, whether he be of little or great learning, but let love of simple truth lead thee to read. Inquire not who may have said a thing, but consider what is said. Men pass away, but the truth of the Lord abideth forever. God speaketh to us in diverse ways, without respect to persons. Our curiosity is often a hindrance to us in reading the scriptures when we wish to understand and to discuss where we ought to pass on in simplicity. If thou wilt derive profit, read with humility, with simplicity, and with faith, and never wish to have the name of learning. Be fond of inquiry, and listen in silence to the words of the saints. And let not the parables of the ancients be displeasing to thee, for they are not uttered without a cause. Read the sacred scriptures and books of piety with the same spirit in which they were written, that is, read them in quest of truth, for instruction, for edification, and to bring thee to a truly Christian way of life. Read the holy scriptures with faith, humility, respect, and docility, praying the Holy Ghost who dictated it, speak to my heart and change it. While the truths which I read strike and convince my mind, grant that, being instructed in thy law and in thy holy will, by the reading of good books, I may follow them in all things, so that what thou teachest may ever be the rule of my conduct and life.
Thank you.
consider the eternal love which God has borne towards you. For before our Lord Jesus Christ, as man, suffered on the cross for you, his divine majesty contemplated you in his sovereign goodness and loved you exceedingly. But when did he begin to love you? Even when he began to be God. But when did he begin to be God? Never, for he has always been God, without beginning and without end. So he has always loved you from eternity, and in consequence of this love, has prepared for you those graces and favours which he has given you. Hence, speaking to you as much as to any other, by the prophet Jeremiah, he says, I have loved thee with an everlasting love. Therefore, with loving kindness have I drawn thee. And amongst other things, he caused thee to make firm resolutions to serve him. O God, what resolutions are these which God has thought on, meditated, designed from all eternity? Ah, how dear and precious ought they be to us! What ought we not to suffer rather than give up a little of them? No, if all the world should perish, for the whole world is not worth one soul, and a soul is worth nothing without good resolution.
panem de celo praesis isti eis, omne delectamentum in se habentem, oremus. Deus, qui nobis sum sacramentum mirabili, passionis tuae memoriam reliquisti, tribue quae sumus, ita nos copris et sanguinis tui sacra mysteria venerari, ut redemptionis tuae fructum in nobis iugit essentiamus, qui vives et regnas in saecula saeculorum.
Blessed be God. Blessed be God. Blessed be his holy name.
Blessed be his holy name.
Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man. Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Blessed be his most sacred heart.
Blessed be his most sacred heart.
Blessed be his most precious blood.
Blessed be his most precious blood.
Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be St. Joseph, her spouse most chaste. Blessed be God in his angels and in his saints.